Good morning. I was checking my Twitter account, excuse me, my X.com account. And there was an old video there about where to sit in a restaurant on the first few dates. On the first few dates, you sit at 90 degrees, and that reason is so she can touch your arm with her arm. Nice joke, or could you pass me the ketchup or something? You want her to touch you so you can get this ball rolling. She has to touch you first. And then I was explaining to the guy that first few dates at 90 degrees, and then later you want to be facing her across the table or across the coffee table. And I was in grad school, and the assistant professor was exactly my age, 36. She had big tits and very pretty, Susan Webster. And she had a PhD and seemed normal to me, but now remember I told you in grad school they don't know what the fuck they're doing. So I would sit in a circle with them, six, seven kids. They're all kids except me and Susan. And I would sit directly across from her with my legs slightly apart, pointing my dick right at her. It was only a matter of time until we were having lunch, and only a matter of time until we were fucking. So, Susan Webster, wherever you are, you were one of the first where I tested that theory from body language. Thank you. You were a good fuck. By the way, she used to like to get me to kneel on the floor, get on my tailbone with her clit and rub it just like she's fucking me in the ass. My character. Susan, wherever you are, it was fun. She's the oldest girl I ever fucked, by the way, except for Dawn, who is 47. But that was recent. A girl named Siri Hansen did not get in any of the videos, and I learned a lot from her. It lasted about 3 months from the beginning until the final scene, and then there was one epilogue after the final scene. But there were two good-looking girls about 27. And my friend John Dempsey and I, who was about my age, were in Nathaniel Brandon's weekend self-growth seminar, 3 days long. And these girls came on a whim. And that's a very expensive whim. That was about 2,000 bucks. But this is in the middle of the human potential movement in the 70s, where everybody was going to these seminars and experiencing life, doing nude therapy, nude workshops, encounter workshops, learning how to argue workshops, all kinds of workshops all the fucking time. And they didn't realize they walked into the most famous therapist in Los Angeles, Nathaniel Brandon, who was Ayn Rand's protege. And he was like a celebrity. He couldn't go anywhere and people recognized him, hound him for his autograph and all kinds of stupid shit. And he really resented that, but nothing you can do about it once they know who you are. Anyway, they came to one of his workshops, and during the workshop, there's sessions where you tell the truth, and you do it through various exercises. And you start out working in a group, and you go around and you tell everybody in your group, say 10 people sitting in a circle, something truthful about you, and the braver you are, the better. So the more risk you're willing to take, the more you learn about yourself, the more you learn about your shortcomings and your strengths by just being truthful. This is new to most people. Most people haven't ever told the truth, even to themselves, since they were about 15. It's a shame because if you're just real, life becomes so much simpler and time lasts so much longer. All right, enough preaching. Watch my videos on being here now. So where was I? Siri Hansen. So John Dempsey and I met these two girls, and we made an agreement to get together in a couple of days at the other girl's house, not Siri's house. And she lived in the Hollywood Hills. Now that's even in those days, that took an arm, a leg, and an arm. But it was just so fucking cool. It's in the 70s, man. We're on Sunset Boulevard driving up into the Hollywood Hills to see these two girls we met at a growth workshop. Now, that doesn't get any more 70s than that, okay? So we're in her house and we're smoking dope and just hanging out and talking. And Siri and I, for some reason, come up with an excuse that we're going to go take her car and go back to her house. So we go to her house, and she lives in Redondo Beach, which is just from the title should tell you, takes money to live there. So these girls are both kept women of some kind, but we're not putting two and two together yet because there's no way they had that kind of money at 27. At least I'm not putting it together. So Siri and I are there, and we have a good sex. She wants to fuck in the back of her Volkswagen bus. You remember those buses? So she's a wannabe hippie, rich girl, kept girl. So, okay, I don't get it. Whatever gets you off. And so she's got her fucking heels straight up in the air, like that. As wide open as she can be. And she's screaming and screaming and screaming, give it to me, give it to me, give it to me. Which turns me on because the girls I go out with aren't 27, they're 22, 3, 20, 21, and none of them deal like that. We continue for about 3 months. And I had just gotten my Jaguar fixed for the 8,000th time. I had a Jaguar E, which I had wanted all my life. I got one and I spent most of my time working on it. Don't ever buy a Jaguar unless it's a new Jaguar. And don't buy one that somebody put a Chevy in. That's even worse. The balance is wrong, the geometry is wrong. I mean, it's just stupid. Don't do it. But it's the most beautiful car ever built, by the way. Enough of that. So Siri and I are sitting in her kitchen on some warm summer evening, and I just parked my Jaguar in front of her house. In Redondo Beach, they have these big wide streets where the rich people live, just double wide. And the houses have big lawns way back. My Jag's up front, belongs to this house, is the point. A guy comes in, he's about 5'8", some sort of a snub nose. Could be a Magnum, could be a 38, I don't know what the fuck it is. All I know is I'm scared shitless. He says, "You get the fuck out of here." And so I got the fuck out of there. I get home and she calls me. I said, "What the fuck, who was that?" She said, "Well, that's my ex-husband." Well, he's not an ex-husband yet. We're separated. We've been separated for 6 months. That's how she could afford to live there. I said something else, and she said, "Will you testify against them for me?" I said, "You got to be fucking kidding me. No, don't ever tell them my name. Don't tell them where I live. Get the fuck out of my life. You think you know somebody. You don't know anybody." 3 months of fucking, 3 months of having a good time in life. No mention of the ex-husband ever. I don't know what I assumed, but obviously what I assumed was the wrong fucking thing. Okay, that's enough of Siri Hansen.